Welcome to the first ever IoTeX Idea-Thon. As we count down to the official launch of Pebble, we're excited to hear how you will use IoTeX technology to make our world a more trusted place. In this video, we explain the various types of use cases that Pebble will empower and equip you with all the tips and knowledge you need to create your best Idea-Thon submission. Pebble is a first-of-its-kind device developed by IoTeX and Nordic Semiconductor, a world-leading IoT chip manufacturer. By combining tamper-proof hardware and tamper-proof software, Pebble generates data that can be verified and therefore trusted by anyone. At a high level, you can think about Pebble as a trusted robot worker, an unbiased third party that delivers verifiable data to blockchain applications and builders. Pebble does this by capturing data from the real world and cryptographically signing it using a built-in secure element, similar to the ones used in smartphones to manage your fingerprints and crypto hardware wallets to manage your private keys. Once signed, data is transmitted and hashed to the blockchain for provenance, almost like an on-chain birth certificate. The cryptographic signature and time-stamped blockchain record allows anyone to verify the authenticity of Pebble data, establishing a new standard for trust. Trusted data from trusted devices to feed trusted applications. Pebble is a sophisticated piece of hardware that utilizes components from Nordic Semiconductor, Bosch, TDK, PMT, and more. It is jam-packed with sensors that capture a variety of real-world data. But we aren't here to talk about the hardware. We are here to talk about the use cases. When we think about use cases for Pebble, it's important to understand the flow of how sensors will generate data that forms insights that then trigger actions. Let's break it down. Pebble is equipped with a variety of sensors that record data about the real world, such as location, temperature, humidity, air pressure, air quality, angular velocity, acceleration, and light. All of this data, but what can we do with it? The truth is, raw data alone is not useful. What we are interested in is the insights we can generate from analyzing this raw data. For example, raw GPS data can tell us much more than where we are on a map. It can be used to derive insights such as proximity to a person or place of interest, the distance or route traveled over time, or whether someone is inside or outside of a geofenced area at a specific point in time. Environmental and climate data can tell us whether an asset's environment is too hot or too cold, too dry or too moist, or too dirty based on predefined thresholds. Motion data such as angular velocity and acceleration give us insights into how an object has moved over time, whether it's been dropped, kept upright, or even whether it's moving fast, slow, or not at all during specific times. Finally, light intensity can give us insight into things like whether a package has been opened or not. Using these verifiable insights, we can trigger verifiable actions via smart contracts. By defining business logic in the form of, if this insight is true, then trigger this action, we can use Pebble insights as inputs to trigger any number of actions via smart contract, including sending a payment via IoTeX, stablecoin, or even fiat, advancing a workflow using predefined rules, or even selling data to select users or businesses. Now that we understand the basic flow of sensor data to insights to actions, let's think about the overall structure of our use case. When we think about a use case, there are four main components: the subject of your use case, the insights you want to know about your subject, the time frame in which the insights about your subject are relevant, and finally, the actions that would be taken given different insights. This high-level framework is great for ideating and evaluating on different use cases, but the detailed design of your use case requires some additional insight into the varieties of use cases that Pebble can support. Let's walk through a few examples. This first example uses a single metric from Pebble to create a decentralized insurance use case. The real-world scenario is ensuring vaccines are shipped at optimal temperatures. In this case, the subject is the shipment of vaccines, the insight we want is the temperature, the time frame is the entire shipment, and the actions are automated payments based on the handling of the vaccines. This usage of Pebble is a win-win for all parties involved, where Pebble serves as a trusted third party to incentivize the safekeeping of these important vaccines. This vaccine use case uses only a single insight, but multiple insights can also be combined into one use case. In this example, a car rental company wishes to incentivize renters to take good care of their vehicles. By using Pebble as a single version of the truth, we can determine whether the driver has gone out of bounds, smoked in the car, or driven off-road. In this case, several insights based on different metrics collectively determine whether the renter did in fact abide by the rental terms and whether they qualify for a good driver discount. Another category of use cases is data as a service, where Pebble data and insights can be shared with other parties under specific conditions. In this example, a food delivery service such as DoorDash decides to share verifiable data about not only the real-time location of the delivery, but also the condition of the food throughout the delivery. Imagine Pebble is built into delivery containers in the future. Once the container leaves the restaurant, the customer is authorized to see the condition of their food until the delivery is completed at their doorstep. In addition to the use cases where the resulting action is to trigger a payment or offer data as a service, your use case can also trigger an entirely new workflow in both a linear and non-linear fashion. A linear workflow is one that has a finite number of workflow steps that are executed in a sequential manner without any variation in the workflow itself. For example, in a Pokemon Go style game, verifiable insights from Pebble, such as whether a person is inside or outside of a geofence, can be used to prove completion of milestones in the real world and unlock sequential new challenges in the digital world. As a more dynamic example, let's think about a non-linear workflow where there is not a sequential or finite number of workflow steps. In the future, autonomous taxis will shuttle humans around, but will also need to make real-time decisions based on verifiable insights. For example, whether to seek the next ride or return to base for refueling or maintenance. In this case, verifiable insights about the vehicle's status and location will be used to determine the next steps in a non-linear fashion. Now that you know the ins and outs of Pebble use case design, it's time to put your ideas into action. The theme of this Idea-Thon is closing the trust gap and is all about exploring areas in our personal and professional lives where trust is absent today and how Pebble can close trust gaps by establishing a single version of the truth. The sweeping lack of trust in our institutions and rapid emergence of misinformation compels us to reconsider what we trust and why we trust it. In the future, trust will not be simply assumed, but rather proven with verifiable facts. This Idea-Thon will allow you to implement the concept of don't trust, but verify in the real world. To enter, share with us your best idea that uses verifiable data from Pebble to solve a trust gap in today's modern world. You should first explain the trust gap that your idea solves for and why it is important to you and to society. Next, you should explain your use case idea using the framework we explained in this video. What are the subject, insights, timeframe, and actions of your use case, and how does your idea solve the trust gap you chose? Finally, you should prepare a visual that explains or supports your idea and include any relevant media links that highlight the importance of your use case. The Idea-Thon winners will be selected by community-wide vote, and there are thousands of dollars of prizes available. We will accept submissions starting January 4th through mid-January. Get ready. We can't wait to see what ideas you come up with.